Hey guys, welcome back to War on Mechanics. Thank you guys for watching and subscribing to the channel. In today's video, guys, we're going to share where the serpentine belt tensioner is located and how to release the serpentine belt on BMW 3 and 4 series. As you know, guys, BMW 3 and 4 series, they share the same platform, same engine has been used. It's practically almost the same vehicle, guys. And we'll show you that today. In addition, guys, every single car we get at the shop, we make at least 200 videos, guys. And specifically on this BMW 3 and 4 series, we'll have more than 300 to 400 videos. Why? Simply because our mission at the shop is to save you guys as much money as we can. All we need in return, please subscribe to our channel and like the video, guys. Hopefully you will find the information helpful. Now, if you guys need to buy a new serpentine belt, new tensioner, any special tools, guys, for your BMW, check out, guys, the links in the description of the video below. We share all that, guys, for your convenience. So, let me show you what we'll be doing here today. This is a 328 that we'll demonstrate on, but if you have a 320, 420, 428, procedure will be the same. So, step number one, guys, okay, we're going to actually remove, okay, the air filter box. That's the first step that we're going to do. We're going to disconnect the mass airflow sensor. Okay, so press in here. Pull it out. Perfect. Now, let me release that cable for the hood latch. Okay, perfect. This one is ready. Now, guys, okay, right here, let me show you. Okay, I'm trying to focus quick. We have one hose clamp that we need to get loose. This is for the intake hose. So pre-loosen that one with a, okay, with a flathead screwdriver. And now, guys, okay, that's the air filter box. Okay, perfect, just like that. We have three rubber bushings, one here, here, and here, guys. And gently, okay, without damaging anything, okay, we need to start pulling that thing out, guys. Okay, perfect. Now this one came in. Okay, great. Now, guys, I need to go ahead, gently pull it out. Now we have one vacuum line here, but we can just flip it on the side. Okay, perfect. Now, super important at that point, not to drop anything, any dust or anything, clean it really good in your intake, because that will end up in the engine, guys, and you don't want, okay, you don't want to drop anything, you don't want any dust there, because that can ruin your engine, guys. So, looking at it now, guys, okay, looking at it here, check it out, this is your serpentine belt tensioner, guys. This is the tensioner. Now, stay with us, we'll show you how to release it. We just made the video, guys, the whole video for the serpentine belt tensioner replacement. Serpentine belt, it's on our main mechanical channel, Auto Repair, guys. Okay, we, guys, have quite a few videos taking the whole car apart. I mean, all the way apart, replacing timing chains on that engine. That's a timing chain that we replaced. And also, guys, you find quite helpful information, mechanical information. World Mechanics, it's more of an informational channel, show you where things are located, if you want to fix, try to fix them on your own. And if you guys want to check out our electrical channel, we'll be uploading how to fix engine lights, airbag lights, transmission lights on that BMW, and how to diagnose different electrical components. So, now, guys, with that air filter box removed, okay, that's the tensioner, and right here, guys, you're going to install, okay, a ratchet, a socket that size. I think, cannot confirm for sure, but I think it was 16 millimeter. So you install it, okay, and what you're going to do, you go clockwise, okay, to release the belt, clockwise, and it's going to come loose. And you can see all we have on the bottom is the crankshaft pulley, AC pulley, and this is, guys, right here, the alternator. So pretty simple design. Hopefully, guys, the video will be helpful to any of you trying to figure this thing out. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe and see you guys next time.